The thrill for me is getting a quiet, unison, beautiful tone with no instruments, just the instrument of the child's voice, singing beautifully, all together, and everyone is gravitating to just what that sounds like, and then stopping the sound. That's incredible. I'm Francisco Nunez. I'm the artistic director and founder of the Young People's Chorus of New York City. I came together at American Young Voices just 2 years ago, and when I met the founder's son, Ben Lewis, I found out right away there's a lot of similarities between what I've been doing for the past 30 years and what they've been doing for the last 20 or so years. I noticed it was something a little different about what he was saying. It was not just about music or a concert. It was about people. It was about teachers, and it was about community building. And the way it started, what he told me, was that his father went to a stadium. I think they were playing rugby. They created chants, and they would sing with each other. His father brought together a group of men and put them all around the stadium, and they had signs of what song they're going to sing next. And he expected only those guys to sing. When the song was selected, next thing you know, the entire stadium started to sing along. Thousands and thousands of people were singing along. He decided to then put together a big group of men and create these mass choirs. That grew. His son, Ben, brought that over to the children's choir movement, and that's been growing and growing and growing. He says, we would like to try that in the United States. We're not sure how it would work here. Do you think it would work here? And that's when we started to talk. And let me tell you, it's working here.
My name is Erin Smith. Music education is my passion. Working with children is my passion. It fuels my spirit. It is who I am. It is my life's breath. What is this Young Voices thing? It's in England. I've never heard of it here. You know, how is it going to benefit me and my students in my classroom?
Young Voices is a place where we are able to reach thousands of young people through a core curriculum that's been developed through this repertoire. So we send out a concert with lesson plans, notes, workshops, communication, and a community that can talk to each other on a regular basis. Those teachers then are able to look at this entire set of music, prepare it, knowing that they're going to be part of a much larger picture. And we come together in a very special place, an arena, and we create an entire concert, a professional concert for an audience with everything from lighting to sound to guest artists. And the main artist is the children's chorus.
It's all inclusive. It is for everyone. It can be for a choral ensemble, it can be for a general music class, it can be for a community choir, it can be for a scout troop. It's for anyone who wants to sing. It is not just about the concert. It is this whole arc of a journey that a music teacher is going to sign up their students in September. They'll get their materials later in the fall. They're the ones working with this material up into the concert. There might be a music teacher who has a band background who's all of a sudden teaching general music or chorus class. Well, in the conducting notes or in the lesson plans, here are some tips to get that choral sound that we need. The materials are comprehensive in that there's different levels that we provide. So depending on the age group, so American Young Voices is open to second through eighth grade, so elementary to middle school students. And then it's all backed by these national standards that an administrator can look at and be like, okay, this is important stuff.
What the teacher gets out of this is an inspired young person, incentive to stay in the chorus because they know they're going to be able to go into this big concert, and they get a network of other teachers so they can talk to them and say, and a teacher that's much further away, maybe not just, they already have a network in their own community, but this is opening up that network.
As a music teacher, there's a tremendous amount of isolation you feel in your building. You are the only person in your building for the most part. I know I felt that, and I take pride in making that community with the teachers that participate in our program.
Community for me is a moment where we get to see who we are by being the most vulnerable. When are you most vulnerable? When you're giving your inside, your soul, your spirit. And we share that through music.
They have a network of people that care about them, that understand you are not alone, maybe physically alone in your building, but you are not alone in music education, and what you're doing is important, and I'm here to help you. I think administrators like the fact that this is something that we can budget for. It's not going to break the bank.
I've conducted in all the great halls around the world with hundreds of children. We're conducting in an arena with thousands of children. I'm not talking to 8,000 children. I'm talking to every child individually. That's the way I see it. So for me, Young Voices is an opportunity to help inspire young people to love to sing by building a very large network of teachers and children from around the area, around the country, on this concept of a curriculum or a musical concert.